Previously on Herbert S. Toddleton's Hell Hour.
And people don't give it one back, you're like,
That's so it's like that was on my show.
Never mind, just kidding. I was just joking, I wasn't gonna do that.
Damn it! Look, you've quickly come being the most charming guest on my show to being the most rude.
These people that can give you a high five.
Yes, you've done the slick hand move and you offered a kiss and then you took it away just as quickly as you gave it.
No, I'm not kissing you on your show. I'm not coming on the show and kissing you, so sorry. I'm gonna leave.
Please, Nicole. No, we have... Bye. We have 20 minutes. I have suffered for far too long at your slings and arrows. This will be my retirement. This will be the last stream of Herbert S. Tuttleton's Hell Power. Hey everybody, we did it! Wow, it's Herbert S. Tuttleton's retirement party! Leave your gift at the door and come on in and have a piece of cake or whatever you got. Anyway, come on in, this is gonna be the last one, so we're gonna give a real big cheer for Herbert S. Tuttleton! And boy, Kate Lambert is here! She's gonna wish Herbert a real big happy retirement! I can tell, and there's not gonna be any bad problems at all, so here we go! Might as well have one last mistake. This whole stream has been a GD mistake from the beginning. I guess if anyone's counting, this is mistake number one to the end. This is the final mistake that I will ever make because we are ending this. This is the end. This is my retirement party. So if you have cake, great. If you have a gift for me, which you should have brought, if not, then you don't know anything about a retirement party. I have 5 10-year pens on my desk that I will give to myself through the course of this stream. One for each 10 years that I've spent on the stream. In a total of 5, I've spent 50 years. At least it feels like that being on this stream. No gifts, says RP Havens. RP Havens, I can only assume, is Randy Paul Havens. Thanks for getting on your personal account today, buddy, and not hiding behind your moniker. Very good. The poop emoji is even more stressful to me because it's mocking me with every little chat that you come up with. So thank you for that. This is the retirement party. Let's check in on the chat one last time. Let's do a real fade to 3,000. That's 3 seconds of fade for those counting at home. What do we got here? KP Senti is very sad, and as well he should be. KP Senti has been a loyal follower to the beginning. He was a follower on Adult Swim streams, and he's a follower here now. KP Senti, we thank you for your attendance, and you can now be set free, finally, from this hell hour. One last time. Just leave. Whoops. Oh, you never retired. Well, let me tell you. Retiring just means that you leave your job and you get a small token and you have to find another job. Ah, Danger Mouse. So now we have 2 Randy Havens. One is a clone and one is the real. We'll have to find out by pointing a gun at one of them and the real one will show his true colors and then we will know it is the true Randy Havens. Screw you, Tuttleton. Panties all spaced out, as we know. I have blocked the word panties from being said on the stream, yet everyone finds a workaround to get it on the chat. So thank you, Danger Mouse, for reminding us how we can say panties on the chat. Well, thank God that Nicole Thurman has broken my spirits and has caused me to spiral into a deep cyclone of depression. If there was a rival for the show, I guess it would be Nicole Thurman, but there are not going to be any more episodes after this, so I guess the erotic panties, how are people getting around this? That she would be my rival, but since we are not doing any, then she's not my rival. She is just a rude person who walked in, kicked the door down, and we will sue her for every penny she's worth. There will be no Pepsi party. There will be no Pepsi points this episode, despite many people's tryings and doings in the chat. So that program has ceased to exist. I'm not getting anything for there. I will get right into it because this is our last show, and there's nothing more that I want to do than really plow through this at a grueling pace. So we've got an hour to fill, and boy, I've got an hour of content for you. She is, you may have seen her on Teachers on TV Land. She was on Reno 911 on Quibi. The time it takes you to take a good dump, 15 minutes is a Quibi, as I call it. Ah, I really tickled myself. Boy, what a last one. Anyway, she has been on many things, been credited for American Dad. I'm trying to read these out. Part on American Dad. I don't need to introduce her because her reel will do that for you. May I now present the reel of our guest, and you will figure out everything she's done. So please take a look.
One and a two, and you know what to do.
Welcome, my dazzling divas.
The kids in the pool are black.
Yes, they're black.
Shut up. Shut the fuck up. Kids that are black in your pool are not bothering you. What are they doing?
They're drowning.
They're drowning. No!
And to the right, to the right. I'm on top of the world! God, I'm a Sorry. Yeah. What is this, amateur hour?
How do you like them apples?
We're just a couple old married ladies.
It's a 99% match. I have a match! I knew there was someone out there for me. I'm supposed to be a wife, not have a job. Oh my God, I'm gonna be somebody's wife. I did it! I'm gonna get out of this godforsaken place!
I had a weird dream about you last night.
You killed me, didn't you?
No, no. It was a positive dream.
Then why were you upset?
This is embarrassing to admit, but it was a sex dream.
I had a sex dream about you once. You were magnificent.
I have set my sights on a summer evening.
I have some exciting news to share. It has been 767 days and nearly as many tear-filled nights since I've been able to say this, but I have a boyfriend! What's this?
I told you I wanted to get back together.
As in past tense?
I still do.
Me too.
They need to see me as the alpha lion of this pride.
Well, if they'd seen the way you took me in the back of your Forester this morning, they would. Good luck. Loser.
Yes, of course. We watched her entire reel. Of course, I will be interviewing the famed Kate Lambert on a segment we like to call the Actor's Nook. Watch some more content.
One of life's greatest mysteries is acting. From the ha-has to the cry-cries, it is something that takes years to master.
Psychos is dead!
But here is your resource for everything acting at the Actor's Nook. Here with your host, Herbert S. Tutton.
Hello, Kate Lambert. You are on screen, and this is Kate Lambert, our guest, everyone. Welcome, Kate Lambert.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, we are delighted to have you, famed actress and writer and executive producer of the show Teachers on TV Land, a great series and very deep romance with Tim Bagley.
Very deep. Deep would be the word to describe it, yes.
How is his emotional valleys?
Bottomless.
Just bottomless, no bottoms?
He has an infinite amount of love and kindness to give, I'd say.
A very giving actor.
Yes, yes, he is. He really is. I never break more than when I'm with Tim.
You never break?
More than when I'm with him. He makes me laugh all the time.
So the chemistry is palpable then.
Yeah.
Well, that is excellent. And that actually goes right into our first question here on the Actors Nook. What is your process? And make sure that it is said that way. What is your process on set and acting? How do you deliver such three-dimensional, vivid characters to the screen?
Well, first of all, thank you for pronouncing it the Canadian way.
Yes, and also how Michael Gelman would pronounce it.
Yes, I have. So yes, I'm familiar. My process is, I'd say, I was a writer on the show too, so I was very familiar with the storyline and the specific lines for the character anyway, but I have an acting coach, Anna Campbell, who I always work with. And memorizing comes pretty easy to me, so I just make sure I'm off book, and that's pretty much it.
What does your acting coach do on a daily basis? If you're on set, you haven't shot, you're off camera, does she really jack you up as far as emotions go to get you ready for a very important scene where you will definitely cry and not fake it?
Well, we never practice the day of. Usually we would do it over FaceTime, just because that was easiest with the hours that we were working. Mm-hmm. But yeah, we would do it probably maybe the night before. Sometimes the weekend before, we do all the scenes that we're going to do that week. And I'd write my notes in and we'd go through everything a couple times. And then I'd have those notes on set. So that's what I would use and look back on.
I see. There is a question from the chat. Everyone wants to know, did you just say that your acting coach is a cannibal?
No, I said her name is Anna Campbell.
Chat, for the record, that's Anna Campbell. I will spell it out. A-N-N-A.
Not a cannibal.
Campbell. I'm just going to do
that. Yes, Campbell. Campbell.
Campbell. Excellent. Mm-hmm. What is your favorite scene? So you're on FaceTime? What is she just like sitting at her house with a little iPad just being like, yeah, do it this way.
She doesn't sound like that, no. But yeah, she'll just give me feedback. She reads the other parts and gives me notes and things like that. Yeah.
Has she gone?
Are you an actor?
What?
Are you an actor?
Yes, I have graced the sets of many films, whether they wanted me to be there or not.
Like so, what?
There was the Pauly Shore film Guest House, starring mm-hmm. Pauly Shore, Steve-O, and a bunch of people from YouTube who are D-list celebrities by YouTube standards. So you can figure what that means.
What else?
I was in the movie, the Trolls World Tour movie. There's a mocap actor. It's a completely computer generated, but they were doing the motion capture, and I wandered in because I was secretly sneaking a script to Michael Bay in the back, and you will see in the background.
Oh, Michael Bay did that?
Yes, Michael Bay did that. He has since gone from explosions to just re-rigging old toys from the 80s and 90s and trying to shoehorn them into a movie that makes sense. So he's doing that. I was not in a mocap suit, so you'll just see a jangly mess of a troll wandering around where like he's moving his arms like they're all broken, and that's me. So the broken troll, the troll who's a contortionist, is me.
Wow.
I can go on. My list is very long of credits. I was in This Is Us.
Oh, wow. Who are you?
One of the people who cry. There's a lot of people who cry in that show, so I'm one of them. They said my scene's coming up, and I cry, so that's all I know.
Can you cry on command?
I must be punched square in the testicles in order to cry, but they willfully oblige me, so that's good. I didn't know that acting was so generous. You said it yourself. People are very generous, and they will gladly kick me square in the balls.
Yeah.
What is a memorable moment, or how does your acting coach really, again, I will say, jack you up as far as emotions go? Does she give you any sensory images? Are you an inside from Are you an inside to out person or an outside inward person? Are you an innie or an outie? Do you have no belly button whatsoever?
I have a belly button.
Innie or outie? Innie?
It's an innie.
What do you think of the opposite, outies?
It's a great car.
Which one, the A4 or the A5?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So A for acting and A for acting.
A for acting. So no, she doesn't like,
she doesn't jack you up.
She doesn't, I would never, I don't think I'd ever use the phrase jack me up, but, I know the character pretty well just cause I played her for so many years. So, she was really great at giving notes of like, come at it from maybe this way, or, you know, play hurt on this line, or do a reversal here, you know, that kind of thing.
Hmm. Interesting. Yeah. Daniel Strauss is in the chat. He says, wow, this is really chapping my cheeks. wow, you stumped her. You're the winner. Yes. In an interview, it is a constant battle to see who is better, the host or the guest. So Kate, be on your toes, because this is a competition and they will judge at the end.
Okay, now I did notice in the beginning you didn't have the audio on my reel. I didn't know you were gonna play it, but the audio wasn't working. What was that about?
No, the audio was working. I know that Randy Havens and Colin Jeffrey like to keep tabs, but it was working. They could hear it, you could not, because I did not monitor it. So you could not hear it, but they could hear it. So I'm gonna count that as a half mistake. It's the last half mistake that I'm gonna make, because this is the absolute last show that we're ever gonna do, ever.
Okay. I wasn't aware that it was your last show, so.
Neither did I.
Yeah. I mean, I understand why, but I didn't know it was your last show.
Yes. Well, speaking of, Kate Lambert, do you have anything you wanna dish on Nicole Thurman at this point?
Love Nicole Thurman.
You love Nicole Thurman?
Yeah, I know you guys have problems, but I love Nicole, so.
She is, I think, very two-faced. She presents something one way, like a high five or a subtle kiss or even a glance, and then takes it away and immediately turns it on its head and back at you.
I mean, I saw the snippet you played. I feel like you're making a really big deal out of something that's not a big deal.
Well, if you were there, I guess it's something you had to be there for.
I was kind of there. I did see a video recording of it, so.
Well, but it was palpable live, I think, because that was unedited, raw, uncut, and the vitriol was palpable between her and I. We were at odds constantly. She played the game that definitely was my game, and I invented it, and it definitely wasn't a game that she plays on her Instagram all the time.
What was it?
Lovers or losers, where I put two pictures together and I ask you to choose which one's a lover and which one's the loser.
But she does do a lot of like games like that on her Instagram, like choose this or that.
Agree to disagree. Very good. Moving on to our next acting questions. Thank you for your abrupt sidetrack onto my pain and anguish from last stream. You have been on Teachers. How is it?
Being on Teachers?
How is it being a teacher? Did you find that you were empathizing with teachers? Did you find a well of emotion and resource that you had not otherwise explored as a teacher? Was the show?
I'm not a teacher, but you know that, right?
No, but the show is called Teachers.
Yes.
So you are all teachers.
Yes, where I play a teacher. So I think, you know, definitely, I feel like growing up, you always see your teachers as like so much older than they really are. And the show sort of explored that teachers, even though they're like molding America's youth, are also, these teachers are also sort of figuring out their own lives. And they have a very difficult job and not enough resources or pay. And yeah, I have all the respect in the world for teachers.
Good answer. You win that round.
Okay, great.
That's one round for Kate Lambert. If anyone's keeping track in the chat, obviously Daniel Strauss is. Daniel Strauss, that's one for Kate Lambert.
Okay, and how many do you have?
Five. I presented you, that's one. So the guest has to make up in the interview for the host presenting. So the host has a head start. And I've done what is this? Herbert, you are truly the best at being the worst interviewer ever. Okay, I guess take a point away from me. It's still 4-1. It's okay. Still 4-1.
Okay. I'll get them back.
You'll get them back. And I believe you'll get them back on this section. Kate Lambert, you worked and toured and were just whooping it up in Chicago, Illinois with the Second City, of which you toured with Daniel Strauss, who is in the chat. Can you tell me your favorite moment with Daniel Strauss and what that was like and the emotions behind it?
Yeah, I can absolutely tell you my favorite moment with Daniel Strauss.
Really give it to him.
Oh, I will. So we had a thing on tour called Gotcha Daniel, where Daniel is such a wonderful person, but people love to give him a hard time. And we were, God, I wish Daniel was here to make sure I'm telling this right. I'm sure he'll tell you in the chat.
Thank God. But
we were in line to board a plane, and Daniel was behind me, and I gave my ticket to the gate attendant and I got by. And then Daniel gives his ticket to the gate attendant. And the gate attendant says, "Are you the Daniel Strauss?" And Daniel was like, "Did she put you up to this?" And I swear I didn't, but the gate attendant just wanted to make fun of Daniel.
Really got him.
It was a gotcha.
Was that the biggest gotcha in history?
Did you just burp?
Yes, but no, I didn't.
It wasn't the biggest gotcha. No, I wouldn't say so.
What was the biggest gotcha? We'll go with that, and then we will steer away from Daniel Strauss. Most dedicated viewer and a very sweet boy.
The biggest gotcha, I feel like, is only fair if Daniel's here to argue, because it has to do with Kansas. So I'll leave it at that. Daniel knows what I'm talking about.
You mean the famed where he pointed at then couple? No, he didn't point. He just raised his hand as everyone pointed to his side of the stage to give it to Jason Sudeikis and Olivia Wilde.
Yes, but what Daniel says is that he pointed to them first and then waved, and all of us did it wrong. That's what he says.
Well, you know what? We'll get that to that in a second. Oh.
I think he's probably, I'm sure that is what happened, but.
I'm having a call right now. Hello?
I pointed to them.
You pointed to them?
I pointed to, what happened? I'm on the phone. I pointed to them. And then no one else was pointing to them. So I looked over and I said, I guess we're waving. We're supposed to wave. So I waved with everybody else. And as soon as I put my hand in the air to wave, every other moron on stage with me pointed over at Sudeikis and Wild. So whoever was there from the media who took the picture, snapped the picture right as I went to wave, and everyone else copied me and pointed at them. And that's the true story. That is the true story of what happened.
What is I wish I was alone?
That was when Kate and I were at, we were eating in a pho restaurant, I think.
Pho.
It was.
Yeah, and Kate wanted pancakes, but we couldn't find a pancake restaurant, so she said, I wish these were pancakes, and I said, I wish I was alone. All right, I'll let you get back to your show now.
Thank you. Thank you for interrupting. It looks like we've got a three-way between a previous guest and a current guest. We're getting it from all sides in this last one.
He's very passionate about it.
He really is. Wow. He had to call like a weird, like, he's his own like PR person. He's like, no, that's not how we can be reached for comment. And this is what it was.
Oh yeah. I'm surprised he didn't have a statement ready.
He read it right then and there. Speaking of, this brings an interesting topic to light. What are your thoughts on the Jason Sudeikis, Olivia Wilde split?
Oh, I think, you know, I feel so weird commenting on something like that. I think they're both lovely, wonderful people.
Excellent.
And I was so lucky to do that show with both of them, that they were both like really awesome.
I imagine they were, because they were in love, and you can tell that. You can tell that on stage. But also, you may be able to pull your punches as far as the Sudeikis Wilde controversy goes. Here's what I think, and these are the true facts, and I know it, and this is not a conspiracy theory or anything like that. Look, Olivia Wilde was engaged to a prince.
Why are we talking about this?
What? This is a hot gossip. This is hot news.
Well, I don't want to do gossip.
What do you want to talk about, acting?
Well, that's what you had me on for.
Look.
Are those glasses prescription?
Yes, they are -5.
Why are they so yellow?
I can tell that you're trying to get to the piss-colored nature of these glasses, as is very themed in the chat.
Looks like you're looking through two amber rocks.
I have a problem with blue light, and these help me in my times of need. Also, I do not wish to look at the audience as they are. I wish for them to be looked at with rose-colored glasses. Unfortunately, I have to look at them through piss-colored glasses. Thank you.
Okay.
Oh, Daniel says Kate hates gossip. So maybe that's why. Anyway, here's my Olivia Wilde story, and we'll get back to acting. Oh, Daniel just called again. I think Daniel's just going to interrupt the entire time.
Okay, go ahead.
No, I'm sorry. Randy Havens called.
Oh, let him call him.
All right. Oh, yeah, it doesn't say his number. Thank Christ. I almost doxed.
Why are you lying to Kate about your piss-colored glasses, Tuttleton?
I'm not lying. I'm trying to get to it, but everyone knows about the piss-colored glasses from the chat, so just cool your jets.
I won't cool my jets.
Do you have anything that you wish to say to Kate Lambert on this, our last Hell Hour? This is my retirement show.
Hi, Kate.
Hi.
She said hi. You'll have to catch it on the stream 10 seconds later.
Well, tell her I love her.
I love you too.
She says she loves you too. I love this is being translated.
Yeah, ask her about her favorite Randy memory, and I'm going to hang up. Long-time listener, first-time caller.
I'm glad that we are now a call-in program. That's never happened before. Thank God that we can be a call-in program. Maybe I'll set up a fucking hotline next time.
Honestly, this is like a radio show with all these call-ins.
It really is. Like, everyone's on the board. I should have a soundboard that goes beep 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 beep. What is your favorite Randy moment? We will retell that, and I imagine it's in Alaska somewhere, or is it more recent?
Oh God, I'm wondering what story he wants me to tell. What would it be?
I don't know. Is it when you visited ATL? Is it when he came in a truck, when he came to LA? Is it when you were on the Alaska thing? Also through Second City. I like that all these people are through Second City. You know what?
That's true.
If I could have Andrew Alexander call me right now and be like, oh yes, Kate's my favorite, and also I don't own Second City anymore. That's what I want to hear from him. Just that Kate's his favorite and that he doesn't own Second City anymore.
I'm trying to think about the memory, and it's probably Randy and I did a lot of adventures together. We were like adventure buddies on the boat. So we went dog sledding. We did a ton of stuff. And one of my favorite things was we went zip lining in Costa Rica, and I was getting eaten alive by these flesh colored bugs. And they were biting me the entire time. And Randy wasn't getting bit at all. So I like to think it's because I'm so sweet.
Was that a long-winded story to get to a joke?
Well, it wasn't really a joke. I was just trying to think of a way to end it because I knew that the deafening awkwardness of you furiously looking for your next question was going to be so awkward. So I was trying to make it lighter.
I will have you know, I am a professional. I have interviewed the likes of Steven Seagal as he was ordering from In-N-Out. I have interviewed Terry Gross on NPR as I was stealing her microphone, which I have right now.
You can interview a lot of people, but I don't think it necessarily makes you professional.
So you're saying the list of credits that I have do not make me professional. Very well then, you be the interviewer. Go ahead, Kate Lambert, ask me a question on here, the Actors Nook. Do you want me to restart the intro?
Yeah, that'd be great.
All right.
One of life's greatest mysteries is acting. From the ha-has to the cry-cries, it is something that takes years to master.
Thank God it's dead!
But here is your resource for everything acting at The Actor's Nook. Here with your host,
Kate Lambert. All right, go ahead.
Well, hi there. I'm with Herbert S. Tuttleton, and we are going to get down to basics. Who was the first person who broke you?
That would be my mother, as she
clutched. And what was her name?
Her name was Judith M. T. Tuttleton.
And what did that stand for, M. T.?
Muscular Town. Muscular Town Tuttleton.
That sounds real. And
it's like
happened?
A Von, like how the Germans were like Guter von Lichtenstein. She was Judith Muscular Town Tuttleton. She's from Muscular Town in Pennsylvania.
Oh, okay. Is that near like Hershey or?
It's near the coast.
The coast of Pennsylvania?
Yes. The Atlantic coast of Pennsylvania.
Of Pennsylvania.
Yes.
And did you find yourself wandering to the cliffs of Pennsylvania to look over the shores you were a Jane Austen heroine?
Yes. I went to my mother's hometown because I wished to trace my genealogy. It turns out that I come from a long line of burger flippers, and I wanted to see where my mother grew up, which burger she flipped, which burger she didn't flip, and I came to find that she had flipped at almost every establishment. She really was flipping for everyone.
Wow. And have you burger flipped?
Only when I am in disguise in order to pass screenplays to network executives and prolific producers while they are ordering from the following: In-N-Out on Sunset Boulevard, the Arby's on Sunset Boulevard, and the Wendy's on Sunset Boulevard. Sometimes I moonlight at the Burger King on Sunset Boulevard.
Oh, so you're working there and you're putting the scripts into the...
To the burgers.
The to-go bags?
I put my log lines in the actual burgers. And if they are enticed when they bite into it, they will bite into my treatments and scripts.
Wow. Very impressive.
Yes, an unconventional way to get a conventional TV and movie deal.
What would you say is your most significant relationship in your life?
That with my profession. I am married to my profession, and I will stop at nothing to get what I want, which is rubbing elbows with the Hollywood elite and being applauded and getting birthday cakes from Leonardo DiCaprio and Brad Pitt alike. They're in the same room, and they're all laughing, and they're having a great time. And I am just smoking a big, fat, stogie cigar. And people are like, when's your next film coming out? And I look at them and say, tomorrow.
So they would ask you that instead of singing you happy birthday?
Yes, they'd all ask me about my previous accolades and also, what are you working on? I love being asked, what are you working on?
Oh, that's what every actor loves to be asked.
And I like to meander a lot and say, well, you know, I know this guy and, you know, the dream is this, but really I'm doing a lateral move here. And also, I think I really got it. This one thing's going to be the shot anyway. Flipping burgers is fun.
I'm so sorry. I stopped listening.
And that proves that you are not a good host.
Well, I would never have booked a guest like you.
Oh, you would have avoided it entirely.
Yeah.
I know that in past reviews, my presence has been called grating and full of human oil, but I know that I am a very good guest. I am very charismatic and photogenic.
Listen, I didn't want to fight with you. I actually wanted to come on here and have a nice time. I really did. I didn't want this.
Well, Kate, we may not have had a great time in the actor's nook, but I bet that you've gained on me in points because you did a role reversal and you were the host. So you automatically gain 2 points and then 1 point for every question. So I think I need to make up for it, as it were.
Okay.
But let me get another one of these. Again? Yeah. Well, it's the beer.
Oh my God.
Look,
that is so gross to do in an interview.
It's my last show. Cut me a slack.
Is that product placement?
No, we're sponsored by Pepsi. We had a Pepsi party 2 shows ago that everyone wants to do. Oh, fuck, it went everywhere. Look, it's the last show. Might as well let loose, let your hair down, Kate.
Yeah, well, I can't believe I actually did my hair for this.
I know. I can't believe I did mine. I actually put little barrettes in it.
Oh, you did? Cute.
Yes. That is, you can see the tuft coming out of the top here, right here.
Oh, it's an alligator clip.
Yes, that I want my hair to have volume, so I did that.
Cute. Well, that's Kate, that worked.
Yes, I think it does. I think it does. It's a good look. Kate, you have a very, speaking of photogenic, you have a very photogenic dog.
Thank you.
Can you tell us a little bit about your dog and who he is and what he has become?
Well, he's still a dog, but his name is George. He just turned 4 last month. He's a Havanese, and he's just my best friend. He's my best little pal.
He is your best friend.
Yeah.
And you would say that you spend the most time with him out of anyone. Like, no one has spent more time with George than you.
Yeah, I'd say that. Yes.
I unfortunately have to inform you that you are incorrect.
Okay. You think someone spent more time with George than I have?
Yes. And it was I. You did not know this, but secretly, I have spent every waking moment with George Bunbury Banks, his full legal name. This dog has legal rights and rights of a dog. but may I show you some video evidence, or I'm sorry, some photo evidence to show you that I have been with George even when you do not even know that I am there, but I'm always, I am encouraging him. May I present Exhibit A?
Okay, that's in Virginia. You weren't there.
Yes, I flew there by car, and I arrived just as this photo was taken because I felt his presence. He called to me from all the way across the nation, and I knew that I had to cheer him up. So this is me calling to him, and he turns and looks at you, and he wasn't looking sad now. He now looks happy and photogenic. So that is me. You can't disprove that. There's photo evidence here, and that's me.
Clearly photoshopped, and you've like you can see that like it's not even your entire body.
No, it is my entire body. I'm behind those pillars. I want
They're not pillars. If you were there, you'd know that was a wall.
Well, I like to do light touches, and also you don't know that. It could be, and that wall could have ended right there, and I think it did.
No, it doesn't, because I practically grew up on that campus, and I know the wall doesn't end right there.
Okay. We'll get back to that sticking point in a moment. May I present Exhibit B?
Okay, now I know that's not possible because you would literally be in the ground.
No. There's a hill. That's a hill scoops down. It scoops down real deep, and I'm standing below it.
But there wasn't a hill, like, right there. No, it was flat.
Are you a flat earther? Are you saying there's no hills and there's no curvature to the earth?
And that's not what I'm saying at all. I'm saying that you're lying and that you were not there when I took these adorable fall photos of George.
Once again, there is video evidence of this, so agree to disagree. That is me looking at him saying, oh, I'm sad George hasn't eaten today. That's what I'm thinking.
So who do you think took these photos?
A ghost.
Oh, so I wasn't there?
No. These are all ghost photos. I believe that specters capture an image, and I have photo paper that I hold up, and I capture the particles that the ghosts have taken with their ghost cameras. And that's how we get these photos. Exhibit C. I'm in your house.
First of all, that's trespassing.
Well, it's not trespassing if you're not caught. So I was not caught, and I think...
But now there's photographic evidence, so we could technically prosecute. So I'm going to screenshot this right now.
Okay, exhibit B9. He's begging, but I was there because I wanted to make sure that he...
That's again in my kitchen.
Yes.
And so now I have evidence again that you have been in my property, on my property, without my permission.
Fair enough. I will say this.
Okay.
George has spoken to me, and he is a dog, and he has a legal name, and he has legal rights. Much like hashtag Free Britney, I believe he is in a conservatorship where you are the main holder, and you are keeping him from his freedom. That is what I think.
What do you think George wants to do?
I think George wants to be called by his true name.
Which is?
I'll get to that in a second. And I think that he wants to be free. And
go where?
Just pal around with me. Like, you've never taken him into a pub. And I know he's spoken to me and said that he loves dog beer. I love regular beer. He spoke to me. You know how Jackson Galaxy is like the cat whisperer or whatever? I'm the dog whisperer. I hear these things.
There already is a dog whisperer, so I don't think that's you.
There are multiple dog
whisperers. Actually, I think that's copyright, so if I were you, I'd be really careful.
I've already been charged with trespassing. What's a little more legal trouble?
Apparently not much to you.
I guess not. However, I will say this. like The Sixth Sense, I hear these dogs talking. I hear all dogs talking. Therefore, I wish
that's
that...
not like The Sixth Sense at all.
Yes, it
you
is.
Hear dead dogs talking?
No, no, no. Just dogs. Like if the I see dead people, I see dogs talking. That's what I see.
That's like more like Look Who's Talking.
Ah, Look Who's Talking, starring John Travolta and
Kirstie Alley.
Ah, and who was?
What?
On Cheers?
How was I supposed to know? You just said who was blank.
Who was on Cheers, which is a bar, which is where George likes to go and call him by his true name. We will now have a reveal party for George's true name. Please enjoy.
Let's go Hungus. Let's go Hungus.
No.
Let's go Hungus. Let's go Hungus.
No.
It gets better the more times you hear it.
No, I'm not going to name my dog Hungus.
Hungus.
What does that even mean?
That's his true name.
I'm going to look up what Hungus means. It's probably some disgusting sexual
position. No, it's his name. It's a nomenclature. It has no reference. And you know what? We can look it up together. I bet I can look it up. Faster than you.
I already looked it up.
And?
It says, oh my God, I looked it up.
What does it say?
I'm not going to say.
That's an Urban Dictionary. You're not doing it. Hold on. I will now look it up.
But I'm sure it's a word that exists that's probably something that you're trying to make a fool out of me for. Am I right?
Maybe. Wow.
Is it Latin?
What? No, I was going for the Spanish to English translation of Hongo, which means a toadstool.
Oh, like a little mushroom.
Yeah, so call him Mushroom or Roomy.
That's kind
or
of cute, actually.
Mushy. Mushy.
But I'm not going to change his name, but I think that's kind of cute.
That is cute. I'm going to save
that. Hongus, I just feel like every time someone asks me what his name was and I said Hongus, I think that would just... That would be difficult for me. Because people would say, what is it? And I'd say, Hongus.
Yeah.
And they'd be like, I don't know. And I'd be like, H-O-N-G-U-S, Hongus.
Let's go Hongus.
It's crazy. People would be like, I want to take a picture with it.
The video's good. I won't lie. I can't be mean to you about the video. It's good.
Thank you. At least on my retirement show, something has been at least markedly funny.
Yeah, it's good.
Oh, God. Wow.
I don't think that's his real name.
It could be. You just have to change it.
I think it's George. He's very George-like. I mean, look at his... Show the photo again. He looks like a George.
Oh, you mean this
one? Let's go Hungus! Let's go Hungus.
Yeah, that was a photo.
That's exactly what I meant.
Yeah. Well, this is indeed a very jovial retirement party. There is one last thing, though, Kate, that you must do.
Well, first of all, I don't have to do anything.
I beg to differ.
Okay, what do you want me to do and I'll think about it?
I have a bone. I have a bone here.
I'm not going to kiss the bone.
You must kiss the... We will... Here. There we go. And the kiss that Nicole Thurman never gave me. Old bones wash away. Turn to dust and renew thyself in a new image. And now... Kate, kiss the bone.
No.
Kiss the bone. Kate, you're batting the bone away. Come on, kiss the bone. Kiss the bone. Kiss the bone. Come on. Kiss it. What are you doing? Come on.
Listen, I think it's really creepy that you're making a woman like kiss a quote unquote bone.
I see that. Well, I kiss the bone.
That's true. You did kiss the bone.
I think that you're overtly sexualizing the bone, whereas I think the bone is just a bone, and more specifically a femur in this point.
Whose femur is it?
My mother's, Judith M.T. Tuttleton's.
Judith Musseltown Tuttleton?
Yes, from Musseltown.
Who cleaned the bone?
Who cleaned the bone?
Yeah.
A doctor.
No, I'm not kissing it. I'm sorry. I don't want to.
The bone has gone away and has not been
blessed.
Your
mother's femur.
Yes, but the rest of her is, you know, where it needs to be.
Where?
I gotta get back to you on that. But they're there. Trust me.
So wait, does she have her leg amputated? Like, is she still okay and alive and well?
No, she's dead as a doornail.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thank you. But Kate, I have terrible news for you. Since you did not kiss the bone and bless the old bones away, the old bones are here to stay. That's right. We had such a good time on this show that I am not retiring. I will be going on forever now. This was a little dummy's trick because no one brought me any gifts or any cake or anything like that. No one brought me anything. Therefore, I shall not retire until someone brings me cake, a present, and it must be the right time. This was one of the right times.
I brought you.
That looks like a bone.
It's a doornail. And I thought it sort of connected. I thought it would be a nice gift. So I brought it. And so it's so crazy that you said that your mom was deader than a doornail, and this is what I have.
A door's nail.
So it feels like I give this to you and you could retire and you didn't have to do these shows anymore that no one enjoys.
You're right on 2 of 3 points. I will not name which points you are right on. However, it is my duty. Oh boy. Danger. Randy's really getting in the chat. Here's what I will do. Now,
what is he saying?
He's saying, you said you were retiring. Retire, bitch. This is false. False flags, which is true. KP Senti says that he has closing thoughts he wanted to share with me. KP Senti, the floor is yours. We will wait 10 full seconds for the stream to catch up to you. Please type out your full thoughts in a paragraph form, and we shall read them while I retire this beer. Kate, what are your plans for the future? Where do you see yourself?
In 5 years.
I was going to say 5 years, but I was going to say post-pandemic. But whichever one you want to take.
Let's see, my 5-year plan. Post-pandemic, I hope to be back in Los Angeles. Well, I will be, but I just don't know when post-pandemic is.
When do you think post-pandemic is?
Oof. I'm afraid to say, because if I am hopeful, then I feel like I'll jinx it. But I feel like I'm hopeful that I would be able to get back to LA in the late summertime. But they're saying on the news and stuff that the pandemic might be going until the end of this year.
Kate, to your point, and to my father, who is a scientist, there will be... What?
I didn't know your father was a scientist.
Yes, Philip J.S. Tuttleton.
Feels like you're searching for those letters.
I don't usually use the middle letters because we're all familial, but I want to make sure that I get it right. We have now, I think, three or four companies, pharmaceutical companies, manufacturing a vaccine. One of them has a one-shot injection. The others have, or I think Pfizer is the only one that has two. And I think that the one-shot vaccines will go to the elderly and people who can't like wait that long. However, the two-shot is up for grabs. So now you got the surplus, and you're like, okay, give it to the give it to whoever, the frontline workers, or probably people who are not less urgent. So you're gonna see like more and more sites opening up. Like UCLA has a site now that I am privy to, because I live off of the cafeterias there, and I saw the tents come up, and I stole a kid's badge, so maybe I'll get a vaccine.
Well, I don't think you should steal anyone's place.
He's not using it. He's just a lowly student who always eats at In-N-Out Burger and doesn't study, and I've watched him for months now, and he's probably an anti-vaxxer. Kate, KP sent you some final thoughts, and I like to read them to you because I think they're actually very poignant. Okay. And it would be even more poignant if I were to truly retire. But as we know, this ass don't quit. So KP Senti says, with time, everything will be forgotten, and so will you. That's what's really sad.
That is sad, but, you know, whatever.
Well, I will not be forgotten, and I will be eternal because I have a great legacy, and I am the best, and people will laud and applaud me and construct monuments to me. So I think that I will not be forgotten, and KP Senti, you are wrong, and that K-pop quote is wrong, and I am the best. Kate, your thoughts?
No.
Kate Lambert quoted at 8:04 p.m. on February 22nd, 2021, no.
Yeah, I don't know. This has like been very unsettling. I've never been a part of an interview like this. I'm uncomfortable. I don't know what to do. It's like,
and that's how I get to the truth.
Yeah, it was just, I don't know, it was really weird.
Are you going to leave?
I mean, I'd like to, yeah.
Well, Kate, we thank your true guilt of obligation to stay here. We have come, unfortunately, to the end of the stream.
Oh, thank God.
So you made it through this turgid roller coaster that is Herbert S. Tuttleton's Hell Hour. We thank you for being the guest. You would have been the last guest had I found the gumption because of this interview. Kate, you have been a wonderful guest, and by that I mean you didn't hang up on me and crush my spirits for one whole week and think about retiring.
Well, honestly, I wish I could say it was my pleasure. I feel like I really disappointed, I'd say, thousands of people who did want you to retire, but
the whole chat.
Huh?
The whole chat. Everyone wanted me to retire. But thank you specifically for giving me the fire in my belly to continue again.
No, I didn't mean to do that.
Thank you very much, Kate Lambert, for being on my show. I am Herbert S. Tuttleton. We'll see you on the next Hell Hour. Great. Thank you so much, Kate Lambert. You have one thing you want to say?
Well, I beg you to reconsider.
All right, thank you. Goodbye. Wow, that's another one in the book. Thanks for watching, guys. Hey, and if you have other money that you want to donate, Cyberpunk is coming out this week. So maybe donate to me. I mean, Herbert, and look at all the cool stuff you get. I got the chair. I don't know what this thing is, but I'm going to want it. And the mug, keychains, and some people say this is tips, but I think it's pretty cool. Anyway, we need your bank account number, routing, and PIN, and grandma's main name. You'd be crazy what they ask for nowadays. And no, Chase, I've been burned before. All right, thanks, guys. guys. See you next time.
Want to die.